Let's talk about these scales, these what we call levels of organization. At the top, you have the organism. Now, not orgasm. That's AMP2. So, the organism is made out of organ systems. You have a digestive system. You have a nervous system. You have a cardiovascular system. There's 11 different organ systems. We're going to get about half of them in AMP1, and we'll cover the other half in AMP2. Each organ system is made out of different organs. You take your digestive system. That's most people are familiar with that one. Give me some of the organs in the digestive system. Stomach. Yeah, stomach, small intestines, esophagus. What else?
Gallbladder.
Is it your pancreas?
Pancreas. Large intestine. Yeah. What else? What's connected to the gallbladder?
Liver.
Yeah. Okay. There you go. So these are not, this is not even all of them, but all of these individual structures are organs in that organ system. And all of these do something to help us digest our food. Now, the pancreas is actually a member of two different organ systems. Anybody know what the other one is?
Endocrine.
Yeah. This is also a member of the endocrine system.
That's why if you have diabetes, you see an endocrinologist.
Exactly, yeah. Because 99%... You go, girl. 99% of the tissue in the pancreas is devoted to digestive functions. The pancreas produces a lot of digestive enzymes that help break down your food, and those enzymes are secreted into the small intestines. We'll talk about that in AMP2. But 1% of the tissue is actually what we call endocrine tissue. It produces hormones, insulin, glucagon, which you probably haven't heard of, and a couple of other ones. These are the two biggies. So you can have organs that multitask. Now, each organ is made up of different tissues. The tissue on the outside, if you picked a stomach up and looked at it, the surface of that stomach is made out of something called connective tissue. If you peel the connective tissue off, underneath that is muscle tissue. In between the layers of muscle tissue is some nervous tissue. And then the inner lining of the stomach is epithelial tissue. So all of the organs in your body are made out of a combination of only four types of tissues: connective, epithelial, muscle, and nervous tissue. Now, what exactly is a tissue? Well, it's a thing you use to blow your nose, right? No, a tissue is actually a bunch of cells hooked together. So if we take the epithelial tissue, we're looking at the lining of the stomach. What you have are a bunch of cells. You put those cells together, and that forms a tissue. And then the cells, each cell, is made out of a whole bunch of different chemicals. Things like the cell's going to have DNA in it. DNA in the nucleus. It's going to have some lipids. It's going to have some carbohydrates. It's going to have some proteins. It's going to have some water. All kind of stuff put together. All kind of chemicals put together to make a cell. So if you put the right set of chemicals together, you get a cell. You put the right kind of cells together and you get a... You put the right kind of tissues together and you get a... You put the right set of organs together and you get a... And you put the right set of organ systems together and you get a... That's easy, right? All right, so we're going to start at the bottom and work our way up. The fundamental building block of all of the chemicals, regardless of whether it's water or DNA or lactose, all of these chemicals are made out of atoms. This is a model of DNA. That's carbon. Oxygen is the yellow ones. Nitrogen, that's green. Phosphorus is red. And the hydrogen is the kind of the aqua. You put those different atoms together in the right arrangement and you get DNA. DNA is a molecule. So even at the chemical level, you've got levels of organization. Atoms put together make molecules. You put the right chemicals together and you get a cell. The cell, let me back up just a minute. The chemicals are not alive. DNA by itself, you can actually have DNA in a little tube. DNA by itself is not alive. It doesn't perform the functions of living things. But if you get the chemicals in the right arrangement, and by the way, scientists haven't figured out exactly how to do this yet. Scientists know what chemicals make up a cell, but they can't just put them in a beaker and mix them up and get a cell. The cell is alive. It is what we call the basic structural and functional unit of life. Anything less than a cell is not alive. And to make all the other things, you start with cells. Now, even though there are only four types of tissues in your body, there in the human body, there's about, you know, give or take a little bit, about 200 different types of cells. This is my favorite one. This is the oocyte. That's the egg. This is the sperm. Ladies, we only have a certain number of these. Guys, you keep making them all the frickin' time. Now, the job of the sperm is to find the egg and deliver the DNA. That's all the sperm has to do. The egg is responsible for every freaking other thing. All of the cellular organelles, like mitochondria and Golgi and things, all of those that you have in all of the cells in your body came from your mother. Because all your dad said was, here's 23 chromosomes, good luck with that. You have different kinds of blood cells. You have red blood cells and white blood cells, and there's actually five different kinds of those that have different jobs. You have smooth muscle cells. You've got cardiac muscle cells we'll talk about a little bit later. You've got skeletal muscle cells. All of those are a little bit different. I have lots of these. These are fat cells. That's one of a particular type of neuron. So, lots and lots of different kinds of cells. And, of course, the shape of the cell enables the cell to do what? Certain functions. Exactly. Okay. This would not make a very good fat cell. This would not make a very good muscle cell. I've tried. These are those four types of tissues. You put the cells together and you get types of tissues. There's an example of epithelial tissue. Here's three types of muscle tissue. This one is skeletal muscle tissue, the kind that you have in your biceps and triceps. This one is cardiac muscle tissue, obviously the type of tissue in the heart. And then all of the tubular structures, blood vessels, digestive tract, urinary tract, anything that's shaped in a tube, anything that carries material of some sort, in the wall of that tube is smooth muscle. When we talked about the stomach up here, this tissue, the tissue in the wall of the stomach is smooth muscle. And then you have nervous tissue. Epithelial, connective, three types of muscle tissue, and nervous tissue. Okay, this is kind of cool. This is the heart. If you take a chunk out of your heart here, this inner stuff, the lining right in here, this is epithelial tissue. You've got some connective tissue here. You've got cardiac muscle tissue here. You've got blood vessels penetrating all of this tissue. And then some more connective tissue on the outside. And then, of course, the organ systems.